About 1 week ago, at the very last day of October, Reiza published a major update for Automobilista 2, which was initially planned to release back in June 2020, but I think we all know how badly COVID messed up Reiza's schedule. The main points of said update are force feedback changes and a lot of new cars, especially completely new GT4, GT3 and Cup cars. Another thing originally planned for this update was the release of the Nürburgring Nordschleife and generally all layouts of the Nürburgring itself. From all these versions, only the GP layouts made their way into the game. However, to compensate for the missing Nordschleife variants, all GP layouts, which originally should have been marketed as a DLC pack, will be temporarily for free in the game and playable until the actual Nordschleife comes in a later update. Regarding the force feedback, there is now a completely new feature, or sensation rather, namely the flat spot. From now on, whenever you lock your wheels, AMS2 will check whether this lockup is flat spot worthy or not. And if this is the case, your wheel will output a slight vibration, depending on the severeness of the flat spot, of course, whenever this part of the tire currently touches the ground. There have also been some minor improvements to the force feedback output you receive whenever you are about to lock up your brakes, in addition to the new flat spot feature. However, the part of this update that arguably spread the most hype among the community are definitely the release of the new GT3 and GT4 cars, maybe even the Cup cars. In more detail, Automobilista 2 now features its own iterations of the Porsche 911 GT3R from 2016, the Mercedes-AMG GT3 from 2015, and the McLaren 720S from 2019, the McLaren 570S GT4 2018, the Camaro GT4R from 2017, and the Porsche GT4 Cayman Club Sport from 2016 in the GT4 class, and the two Cup cars are the current iterations of the 2020 Brazilian Porsche Carrera Cup series. This leads me straight on to my next point, a small review of the GT3 and GT4 class. I'm going to start right off with the GT3 category, as this is, without a doubt, the car class I've missed the most since Automobilista 2's first release. And honestly, the first time I drove a GT3, I think it was the McLaren 720S in Automobilista 2, my disappointment was immeasurable and my day ruined. Just kidding. Of course, I remembered that this game is still Automobilista 2 and its default setups for most cars are horrendous. So, after a bit of, I wouldn't even call it fine-tuning, but rather adjusting the anti-roll bars as well as softening up the suspensions, the car was good to go in my eyes. Now, compared to the GT3 and GT4 only simulator, which is better known by the name of Assetto Corsa Competizioni, the cars in Automobilista 2 still seem to be a bit unstable and twitchy. What also came as a big surprise to me is that the lap times seem to be unrealistically low considering the tidiness of my laps. For example, my best lap on the Nürburgring in Assetto Corsa Competizione, which I myself would consider relatively clean, was about 154 mid to high. However, in Automobilista 2, I jumped in the McLaren again and was immediately able to beat this lap time, even though I thought that considering the tidiness of my lap, I'm somewhere close to 2 minutes. One explanation for this phenomena could be that Automobilista 2 features two different tire compounds, the slick tires and the hard tires, while Assetto Corsa Competizione has one standardized tire. For their difference in behavior, I'm pretty sure that it's not actually Automobilista 2 that is lacking, but as I've said countless times before, it's terrible default setups for the cars, which are badly adjusted overall. Another indication for this are the implemented GT4s in Automobilista 2. Those are the complete opposite to the GT3s. They are fun to drive, not at all twitchy, and probably together with the Formula cars, the most fun you can currently have in Automobilista 2. And I think this is due to the lack of possibilities for adjusting the setup of the GT4 cars, especially the Porsche, when compared to the GT3's. Like for the GT3's, you can adjust their aerodynamics, your anti-roll bars, your suspensions, your tires, and on and on and on. While for the GT4's, these areas are mostly locked, apart from the aerodynamics, of course. But even the aerodynamics have a lower variety of settings. In the end, I think it's fair to say that with the right setup, the GT3's will possibly feel almost the same as the GT4's, but a bit faster. The GT4's are perfectly adjusted as they currently are, and there's no need to play with the setup in order to get the best out of them. So yeah, this was it from my side for this Automobilista 2 update. If you enjoyed this video, you could consider subscribing to this channel for more sim racing content. And with that said, I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers!